guys, Alex here, guitarforest.com. So today we're going to take a look at Symphony of Destruction by Megadeth. And this is going to be a lesson on the rhythm guitar parts only. The lesson on the solo is going to be on a separate video and it's going to be available at guitarforest.com. When I'm done with it, the link is going to be in the description box down below. The tabs and the backing track are going to be available for free at guitarforest.com as well. And I'm also going to post a link to the sort of cover playthrough of this song, which is going to be on my other channel. The link is also going to be in the description box down below. The tuning for this song is standard, and for the sound I was using VST plugin Amplitube, VST plugin. I'm going to show you the picture of the preset that I was using for this lesson and for this song, for this cover. While you're checking out the picture of the preset, I'm going to play you my low E string so you can tune up and play along with this lesson. Alright guys, so let's go for the close-up and start the lesson. Alright, so this song has three distinctive parts. The first part is the intro slash verse, second part is the pre-chorus, and third part is the chorus. And we're gonna break it down part by part. So the first part goes like this. Okay, so pretty straightforward. Here we start off with 1-3-1 on the low E string, palm muted, and then we go into playing two chords, two power chords. The first one is F, go into E, so we have, and we play the E power chord twice with the rest in between. We play it for two times, and then again the transitioning kind of part. Okay, so pretty straightforward. So that's part number one, the verse, the intro and the verse. Then we go into the next riff, which is being played during the pre-chorus, and it goes like this. Watch people's heads roll. So we have, starts off with the two low E's open, palm muted. Then we're going to be playing double stops, which are on the A and the D strings. We're going to go down chromatically, so starting with the 7th fret, 6, 5, but we're going to be alternating each of the double stops with the low E string open, palm muted. So we have like that. When we get to the 5th fret of the double stop, we have a rest. We don't play the low E open. We have a little rest and we play the hammer-on pull-off on the D string, 5-7-5. Like that. And we go right back to the double stop, the first one, which is on the 7th fret. So all together, slowly, is going to be like this. Now, during live versions, the second guitar is harmonizing that hammer-on pull-off. So, first couple times it plays the same hammer-on on the D string, 5-7-5. Second time, third and fourth time, it's playing, it's doubling up, it's harmonizing it in thirds. So, it's playing on the G string, 4-5-4. So, it's right here. Plays it for a couple of more times. And then the last two times, it's harmonizing in 6. So it's playing on the B string, 5-6-5. So as a variation, it goes like this, slowly. Okay, So that's guitar number two, harmonizing the hammer-on pull-off in thirds and in sixths. Dave is just playing throughout the entire riff, just a hammer-on on the D string, 5-7-5. So that's the first part of the pre-chorus, and then we have again sort of like a transitioning part which is being played right after this riff, and I'm gonna play it through first and then we're gonna break it down. So it goes like this. So as you play the riff a few times, in the end, when you get to the fifth fret, the last double stop on the A and the D strings, then we slide out from this double stop, we play the low E string palm muted twice, then we play fifth frets on the A string for a little bit longer, sliding out, and then we go into this part, which is chromatic passage, just going down, starting from the B flat note, which is on the first frets of the A string. So we play one open, and then we go 4-3-2-1 open on the low E string, and the low E open, you just let it ring out. You can play this pattern starting off here, but it's just easier if you start it on the A first, and then, you know, you don't have to move that much on the low E string. It's totally up to you how you want to play it. So one more time, getting to the last double stop on the fifth fret, twice the low E string open, then we have fifth fret on the A sliding out, and then we go into, so all these notes palm muted except for the last one. You play it and let it ring out. So now I'm gonna play the whole riff a couple of times with the transitioning part slowly so you can see what's going on. So it goes like this. So after the pre-chorus riff, we go into the chorus, and first I'm going to play it through, then we're going to break it down. So it goes like this. Okay, so here we have chord progression going on. So what we're going to be doing, we're going to be playing some power chords, alternating them with a power chord with a flatted fifth. So and also we're going to be playing them against the low E string open. So we let all of the notes ring out, and the first chord is E, going to E flat 5. So the pattern goes like this. We start off with the D string, picking D string, then going A, E. So it goes like this. You hold the chord and you play the pattern. Then we simply change that fifth to the flat fifth, and we play exactly the same pattern like that. So we have, okay, then we move down to the D chord and we play exactly the same thing up until you get to the flat 5 here, which is on the 6th fret of the D string. You stay on this note for a little bit longer, it's a quarter note. Add some vibrato, and then we have, so 7 on A, 7 on low E, and we slide out. So these two chords slowly gonna be like this. Okay. Then we go to the next part, which is again using the same principle, but now we go to the C power chord, alternating that with the C flat 5. And the pattern again is exactly the same, so we have like that. Then we move up to the D again, and we play just like we did in the beginning, so just the D power chord. And then we have this transitioning part, which is like that. Okay, so that's the first part, the first round of the chorus. Let me play through the whole thing together, slowly, gonna be like this. After that, again, we play the low E string open. We go through the changes exactly the same way as we did earlier, with the exception of when we get to the C chord the second time. Again, we play it as we did previously. And then when we go to the D power chord, instead of playing that part, we just play palm muted, eighth notes, four times. Fifth time, we hit the whole chord and we slide out. All right? So let me play through again the second part of the chorus, all of the parts together slowly. It's going to be like this. All right, so one more time, both parts together goes like this. All right, so that was chorus number one. After that, we go back to playing verse number two, pre-chorus number two, exactly the same way as we did earlier. Then we go into chorus number two, which is also exactly the same as the first one, but we played two times, two rounds of the chord progression, so it's twice as long. And in the end, they add another ending, which is after you've played the whole chord progression, instead, when you get to the C chord and you play, instead of going right into the D with the chucks, they played just like with the transitioning part. So again, we have, and then playing low E string open again, and then playing the C again. And then second time, we go into the D power chord with the chucks, eighth notes, and we do it exactly the same as we did in the first chorus. So I'm gonna play the last time the chord progression of the second chorus, so you can see how it is changed. So it goes like this. All right, so that was chorus number two. And they do the same for chorus number three in the end. Okay, so after the second chorus, we go into the solo, and the rhythm guitar is playing the riff, which is played during the pre-chorus. With a slight variation, there is no hammer-on pull-off there on the D string. So without this hammer-on pull-off, it's just a rest, and they add another low E string open. So right after the chorus, when we play the D power chord, that's the pattern that they use. So after the D power chord that we play for four times, we hit it fifth time, and then right after that, we go into the low E string, playing it twice open, palm muted, and then we go into the riff. Rest, then we add two more low E's. Like that, so without the hammer-on pull-off. And we play this riff until the end of the solo. coming out of the solo. They play the riff which is being played during the beginning, so verse number three. Going into verse number three, pre-chorus number three, and we end the song with the third chorus, just like we did with the second one, okay? And in the end, it just ends with this first riff, just like that. Alright guys, so that was it for this lesson. Hope you liked it. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. Also, comment, share, subscribe if you're new to my channel. Don't forget to visit guitarforest.com for more guitar lessons. In the meantime, I'll see you again. Take it easy, and as always, let the forest be with you.